let's take a closer look at wind speeds and their impact on construction in the state of Florida. In this map, you can see 115-mile-an-hour isotack at the top of the state. That 115-mile-an-hour line touches a couple of counties in the very northern part of the state. However, everywhere else, the wind speed is greater than 115 miles per hour. The wind speeds throughout the state are high enough to require the use of the Florida Building Code, which is using ASCE 7 as a reference. The shaded areas on this map, areas with wind speeds greater than the 140-mile-an-hour line, are in the middle of the state and the very western part of the panhandle. Those greater than 140-mile-an-hour lines indicate where wind-borne debris protection must be used for buildings that have openings. Looking at this map, it's clear where in the state you need to use wind-borne debris protection and glazed openings to prevent wind-borne debris from entering the building envelope. One of the primary changes with wind speed maps from ASCE 7 to 10 was the development of ultimate wind speeds, and the ultimate wind speeds are associated with a risk category. So, there were two significant changes in ASCE 7-10. First, we modified the occupancy categories from occupancy to risk and defined those risk categories similar to occupancy, so there's designations for 1, 2, 3, and 4. Second, we associated a set of wind speeds for each risk category.